gonna do two things most likely. One of them is right behind me, the Coca-Cola tour. And I'm probably safe to say that most people in the world, if not every single person on the planet, is familiar with Coca-Cola. And right here in Atlanta, the hometown of Coca-Cola, they've got a museum dedicated to that beverage. And the other one being CNN.
Hello, welcome to the world of Coca-Cola. How are you today?
Good.
That's great.
What are we going to see?
The next show is going to start in about 3 minutes, and you're going to see a presentation of artifacts from all over the world, and then you're going to see a short documentary where you see what happens when you put your coin into the slot of a Coca-Cola vending machine. After that, you're going to be self-guided through the rest of your tour.
Had anybody walk in with a Pepsi, and if so, what do you do?
It very rarely happens, but when we do, we just ask them to peel the label off.
Okay, well, I've just spent the last 45 minutes touring the Coca-Cola Museum in Atlanta, Georgia. Now, one of the things you do, of course, you know, at the end of a tour of the Coca-Cola Museum, you're going to get a chance to taste some, but I wasn't expecting actually 64 varieties of Coca-Cola from around the world. I'm looking over to my left here, it says Inca Cola from Peru, Lift Cola from Chile, Simba from Paraguay, and a lot of Nestea from Mexico, and there's another one from Brazil, Della Mate Punch in Honduras. So let's check out some of these different tastes. Best hands down, probably the Incan Cola of all things from Peru. Like that taste the best. The worst, easy. The Japanese veggie bite of drink, absolutely horrendous. It had some kind of a carbonated carrot and celery and pineapple juices in there from the picture of it. Well, I must say the one nice thing about being at the Coca-Cola Museum, you know, they got those beverage dispenser things where you hold a cup underneath. And I don't know about you, but every time I use one of those machines, it always turns out that there's either too much syrup or too much water. It tastes anything but the Coca-Cola that you get in a bottle. But here, of course, when you put that plastic cup under the machine and push the button, you know you're getting the Coke the way it was meant to taste. Now I'm off to the Coca-Cola retail store. I think somebody told me they make 750 different items for sale in that store for the Coca-Cola. Okay, let's see if I can hold onto my wallet and get out of here.